One. Yo! What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, K. Modi. And today, we have our SSL Week 2 matchup against Coach Dougals, coach of the New York Pokemon Rangers, our fellow Tri-State attacker. Yes, it is Week 2. We started off last week 1-0. And 1-0 plus 4, something like that. And then Dougie ended up losing his week one matchup. So I know he's definitely going to want to take this win. And, you know, I mean, Dougie always have great, good matches. So I know Dougie wants to cop that W real bad and try to flex on me as much as possible. but yeah, he's got a really threatening team on his side. He's got Electabuzz, Donphan, Jirachi, Weavile, Pelipper, and Chandelure. While on my side, we've got the physically defensive Arcanine. I think it was max HP, max defense, Impish with Intimidate, with Flamethrower, Dragon Pulse, Morning Sun, and I believe Toxic. This one, this mon was supposed to be my primary switch into Conkeldurr. He didn't bring Conkeldurr, but if he did bring Conkeldurr, this team might have gotten ran through by Conkeldurr. Conkeldurr just kind of wrecked my life. I mean, I could revenge it, but you know, someone might have to die. And it hits like a truck. And I was just like really worried about like a specific Conkeldurr set. So I just like kind of overprepared and just dedicated Arcanine to it. I mean, at the same time, Arcanine was also designed more with Weavile in mind and even like a Fizz Depth Jirachi. Both those two came. So I will have to take that in mind. Next, we have the beautiful Crankankers, rocking with max special defense, max HP, Defog Roost, not Foul Play, and I believe Toxic too. A War One? Something like that, yeah. This is supposed to be my primary switch in for Chandelure, Pelipper, and Mega Sceptile, because he did have Mega Sceptile. If I'm forgetting anybody else, apologies. But those are just the mons that came to mind. The next we have almost Fizz Def, Celesteela, not fully physically defensive, but enough to take max attack Z Inferno Overdrive from Donphan, and then not die in two hits. also, it allows me to turn Ice Shard into a 3-hit KO from Weavile. So that was important to me because I did not want to get flinched out and die like that. But I have Protect, Leech Seed, Heavy Slam, and Earthquake. I had Toxic over Earthquake, but I was a little worried about like Conkeldurr coming in on and getting a Guts boost with Toxic. And then just like running my team. I think you see, I was really worried about Conkeldurr and it didn't even come. And I was just like, oh man, prep so much, right? next we have Gashbell, the Heliwisp with a Choice Scarf set, rocking Grass Knot, Hyper Voice, Volt Switch, and Dark Pulse. This is just to be a attacker and kind of just Volt Switch around, Grass Knot around, Dark Pulse around, do all that shenanigans. Then we have Zynga, the Mega Beedrill, rocking pretty standard set with Max Attack and max speed on Heliwisk. I just put enough speed to outcreep the Jirachi and then put I put some in defense, the leftover in defense, so maybe I could take an Ice Shard from Weavile better. But Zynga has max speed, max attack, with the speed boosting nature because he has Mega Sceptile, and I wanted to speed tie with the Mega Sceptile. And I was just like, man, 2 weeks playing with Mega Beedrill, and 2 weeks I've played someone who speed ties with Mega Beedrill. I'm like, oh, bro, can I just have the fastest unboosted mod, please? It will come, it will come. But yeah, so rocking a pretty standard set with Knockoff, Drill Run, U-Turn, and Poison Jab, just to be here, fastest gold attacker. And then we have Aromatisse with Wish Protect, Aromatherapy, and Moonblast with a lot of defense to take a Poison Jab from Conkeldurr and a Poison Jab. I think it can take a Z Poison Jab from Weavile, halfway decent. And just to be a bulky mon, Wish Pass around, and try to keep popping. My team, my general strategy with this team is to just grind out Dougie's team, honestly, and try to do it as much as possible. And then just wear it down slowly and surely. Looking at his team, though, it's looking pretty offensive, so I have to be very careful. I brought a lot of defensive answers, but I think this team is lacking a little bit of offense, and I was really worried about this going into the matchup, especially if he tries to dial it up offensively. I could be in trouble. So I think, looking at his team, I think the best answer is probably Mandibuzz. He's probably not going to lead Weavile, and he might lead Electabuzz, and in that case, you know, I could switch out. But if you wanted to lead Donphan or Jirachi, or even Pelipper or Chandelure, I think I have a okay matchup. So we're going to lead off with Mandibuzz. And then he leads off with Donphan right here. And I just go right for the foul play just to try to gauge what this thing's going. Because I am, I thought he would go for Rocks right here. So I kind of wanted to get a grasp of what this Donphan attack was. And he goes for the Stonehenge turn one and hits. What I didn't notice, and this was like a total fuck up on my part, I didn't realize at the moment, I know like Showdown like has all the text in the right, but you know, reading's hard. I didn't realize that I got when I foul played that he had Rocky Helmet, and I was just like, oh shit. I didn't realize it until this next play where I decided to U-turn out. And what that does, that was actually pretty big with me and pretty big mess up on my part, was this Mandibuzz U-turned out and it can't come back in on Rocks, which he goes for right here. What I should have done on that last play, which is Roost, total mess up on our part, but what are you gonna do? So I go and just throw up a Wish myself, and then I think I go into Police. Yep, go into Police right here and eat the Flash Cannon and then get all that juicy health back. Unfortunately, I get the Spit F drop, but I'm like, ugh, it's Jirachi, what are you gonna do? I know he's probably not going to stay in here, so I decided to just Toxic right here and lay it down. I decided to switch into Gash Bell, and he goes for the Hurricane. That doesn't do that much, it does like 27%, and I get a lot back because I'm in the rain and I am dry skin. He has to kind of switch here, so I decided to go for Hyper Voice. Probably should have gone for the Volt Switch right there, but I just didn't want to get trapped by the Donphan, to be honest. So I went for just the raw Hyper Voice right there. Does a reasonable amount of damage, but you know, could be better. Could have Volt Switched. And then, so I just go into this on the Toxic right there. And I think right here, I think he Volt Switched right here and goes into the Chandelure. And I just throw up a Wish right here. I think I don't want anything coming on this Fire Blast, so I kind of just let this thing die. I kind of want to see, because most Chandeliers, I mean, it's somewhat common. I shouldn't say most. It's somewhat common for Chandelure to be Scarfed or even Specs. There could be some leftovers, shenanigans, or even AV. But I just want to see what he's locked himself into here. So I go into Police. And I think Dragon Pulse. And that does like 23. That does like nothing. I was thinking about Toxicune right there, but what are you going to do, right? So I'm forced to switch right here, and I go into Master Mold, and he doubles out into Pelipper. Reasonably okay play. Should have protected right here. Don't know why I didn't. Kind of messed up. I actually thought he was going to switch. I don't know why I thought he was going to switch right here. I thought he was going to U-turn or do something along those lines. But he went right raw for the Scald, and I decided to get up with Seeds going and try to get some health back. Look at that name, yo man. Dougie, you be watching, that's disrespectful. So KOK Moody with my old mascot, damn. He goes into Chandelure, and right here, probably should have switched right here and went for the protect, because again, I wanted to see what this thing was locked into. And he goes into the Fire Blast. So, you know, nothing really on my team could take this Fire Blast, not gonna lie. Go into White Girl Rose and Fire Blast misses, thank god this thing misses, and it's called go into the Arcanine, and it's not looking good, guys. I'm not gonna lie, it is looking really bad. This match is looking, getting out of hand. Dougie did really nice in prepping for like kind of my defensive structure, and obviously the early gameplay with Mandibuzz did not help at all, especially with his Chandelure running wild. But I just Morningstone right here, and he Fire Blast, and even on a resisted hit, it's 56, and I'm like, whoa, bro, calm down. And I was like, ah, oh, man, I don't know what the fuck to do. But he goes into Pelipper to reduce my Morningstone, which is a smart play on his part. I think I double out right into Gash Bell, and he goes for the Hurricane. Thankfully, I don't get confused, and we get some Dry Skin damage back. I think right here, we Dark Pulse, and then we get the flinch, and we avoid getting 6-0'd right here, which is really sweet. and then he goes into Weavile. I can't really take anything from this Weavile, so I just try to go into Police, and I think he goes right for the knock, and that does a lot. That does 41, even at minus one. I'm max defense efficient. That's a fuck ton. Damn, Weavile beast. Pretty much. I didn't think it would do that much, to be honest. Then I go into Gash Bell right here, and he switches in. I was so tempted to hit Grass Knot. Guys, I'm not lying to you. I was like, this close. I wish you could see my hands. But I didn't. I'm like, oh, man. Can't get anything right now, right? And he roars me out and goes into Zinger. Kind of fine, I suppose. And I U-turn, and he lives on three. And I'm like, ah, oh, dude, lives on three? Come on, man. And he's Stone Edge is right here. The Celesteel is Master Mold. Yo, Master Mold is getting worn down by the X-Men. And I just see it in a Mr. Seed. I'm like, yo, bro, what? And he Giga Volts Impacts right here. I'm like, damn, man. That's unfortunate. He just does it just stunt. And I'm just like, oh, dude. And then I do Dark Pulse, and it does 50%. I'm like, yo, flinch? And then, nah. Nah. And he goes into Weavile, and he picks me off the Ice Shard, and Weavile cleans up right here. And Weavile picks three kills, and I'm like, ah, oh, dude, Weavile, end the game, man. KO K Moody, he did KO me. Well, good game to Dougie. Played kind of bad there, not going to lie. This is good old Smith. It got beat down. It happens every once in a while. Just some bad prep. Wish I brought more offense. Wish I just diversified my walls a little bit. I was a little stressing out a little bit too much about Conkeller and didn't even come. Played pretty poorly with Mandibuzz. And, yeah, I mean, Chandelure and Weavile kind of have a nice matchup against me. But what are you going to do? It's Pokemon. Yeah, but yeah, good game to Dougie. Watch it, man. Look. We are now 1-1, and everyone in my division is 1-1, so I guess that's the one bright side, right? Next week, we are playing the Faded Andy. I've never played him before, and I'm super excited. I love playing new people. Should be a tough one. We've got a really scary team. And, yeah, we'll see that video next week. And that's about wraps it up. My name is Moody, and I'll see you guys later. Peace.